In this video, I'm going to show you how to make this design right here in Canva using flowers and flower wreaths. I'm going to show you this technique. You can use this technique on any design that you want to do, not just Mother's Day, but any design that has to do with flowers. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005. And I want to help you to learn how to design and sell t-shirts online so you can get some of that passive income. I'm going to teach you how to do a t-shirt design in Canva. I have a lot of Canva tutorials. This time I'm going to show you how to do one like this right here. This is for Mother's Day. I'm going to use flowers and flower wreath and then show you how you can change the color and all those kinds of things. So stay till the end of this video so you can see the whole thing. I'm going to go step by step, and you can do this for free on Canva, canva.com. Let's go to canva.com right now and I'll show you how to do it. So here I am on Canva, canva.com. You can go there, canva.com. And I believe you can just sign in with your email. Once you do that, just create a design here. And I'm gonna go to custom size, and I'm gonna use that 4500 by 5400 pixels. If you don't have this, you can just type it in right here and then hit create new design. I'm gonna click this, and we're gonna have that artboard right there. So the first thing we're gonna do is look for flower wreaths. So go to elements and come here and type in flower wreath. And hit go. And just hit graphics, and you can see there's a ton of flower wreaths. I just found this. You can use this, like I'm gonna click this one just for now. You can see how cool it is. What it is just encircled or some kind of shape, and then you can just put some text in here. It's really easy to do. These would be great for cards if you're doing cards as well. T-shirts, of course, would work well, and a lot of other things. So pop sockets, this would be great for pop sockets too, depending on what you have in there. So. Let's find one. That's one that I like. I want to do one kind of more, colorful is the word. Let's see. I'm going to scroll down, click on this one right here. And I'm going to click on See All. So that's one of the things you want to do. This is very powerful. If you didn't know, on Canva, Seeing All kind of gives you other things that are similar. So See All, you can see all these wreaths are similar. The thing I like about this one right here, I'm gonna make it bigger, is that I can change the color at any time. So if I don't like this color, I can go in here and change it. And that's with all of these right here. So let's just start here, make it big to fill the space. And the first thing I'm gonna do, I don't wanna have the whole thing. I just want the top part so we can crop it. So we can come here and hit crop, or I can double click. If you double click, it's the same thing as hitting that crop. And you can just move these up. So I'm gonna move this up, you know, maybe like that, right there. And then click out of it, and you can see I only have that top half now. So that's really cool. So now I'm gonna just put in text and see what we got. So I'm gonna click on the T button right there. That's gonna start text. That's a quick key to do text. And then I'm gonna put best mom ever, just for fun. This is a Mother's Day shirt. You can put whatever words you want. And because it's with flowers, I'm gonna try and look for a font that's kind of more elegant. So you can come in here and type in elegant. I've already got one. I think it's this one that I used, yeah. You can see here, nice kind of serif font. It looks very elegant, right? So I'm gonna do that best. Just fit it in there. And then I'm gonna hold down option and click on this and drag. That's gonna create a copy. I can do it again right here. So best mom or mother. Let's do mother, that's longer. Best mother ever. That's really cool, right? Best mother ever. And you can start wherever you want there. The next thing I wanna do is I'm gonna look over here to the left and see what kind of flowers I can add. So you can see this flower right here, if I click on it and move it to the front, it's the same flower as that one right there. So I can make this bigger or smaller. It's gonna match my wreath. So all I have to do is, you know, kind of cover that space right there. Now I can turn it any way I want. So maybe I'll turn it upside down or something like that, just so it's different from that one. And I can do the same thing with this. Hold down Option key and click on it and drag, and I made a copy, right? So I can turn this one the other way and make it smaller or something, right? Just to fill in that space. The next thing you can do is look over here for other things that would match. You can see this one right here. I can click on it and it's the same flower. So I got lots of the same graphics, and I'm gonna flip this one and just put it right there. Cool, right? Now I can do the same thing with this. Remember this one? I'm gonna copy that, but then I'm gonna double click on it and then use the bottom part of it instead of the top part. So let's move this up and down and let's see what we got here. No, that's still too big. Let's double click that again. Maybe just come in here like that. Let's see how that looks. Yeah, that's kind of neat. So we can turn this, kind of hide it behind here, right? Isn't that cool? And let's see what else. We can still do this thing. So we're just gonna play around with these flowers and this flower. Let's see, move this here, turn this around. Maybe fill that space right there. Maybe we do two. Let's do two. I'm gonna move that around and then do another one, hold down Option and drag and maybe turn this one like that. Look at that. Make this one smaller, something like that. We can also do leaves. So let's come in here and do this leaf right here. Kind of make it come out like this, make it smaller, you know, have fun with that. And if it's not the same color, you can go in here and click the same color. So if we want to do this and do eyedropper, and maybe we want to make it the same color as this leaf, we can. Or you want to make it the same color as this branch, you can, and put it behind to the back, right? Same thing, we can take this, hold down Option again, turn it, flip it. We're just trying to fill in the space, right? Here, so move this around. Look at how cool that is. So there you go, best mother ever. And now we can play around with some of these things. So if we wanna move the text around, we can. If we wanna add more flowers here, we can. Let's see, what else we got here? Oh, we got this leaf here. Let's say we wanna try this leaf. This leaf looks just like that leaf right there, right? You see it? So we can color it the same too. So we come in here, hit this, do the eyedropper, boom. You don't actually have to do the eyedropper. What you could do is all the colors that are on this are already here. So if I came in here and picked this color, I could pick white, I could pick this color, any of the colors that we already are using in the file, in this thing right here, we can use. So I'm gonna do white on this one, and I'm gonna move this down, and it matches, right? So that's one of the cool things that we can do when we click on these and have all of these graphics, they all match, right? So it's like you're just playing with all the graphics here. And you can put this behind thing, so if you don't want it in the front and you want this one in the front, then this one can, you can just move to the front and do things like that, right? And just move things around and do that. If you want another flower here, hold down Option, make it smaller, you know, maybe this one is the right way, like this. Ta-da. And if you want to change the colors of these flowers, you can too. So you notice that this flower is a lighter flower, that's one a lighter flower. Maybe we make this flower right here a lighter flower by switching up the colors, right? Make that dark, make this light. So really cool. So another thing that I like about this is that I can use the colors in the styles too. So we can go in here and change the colors. Let's make a copy. So I really like this one right here. So what you wanna do is once you find something that you like, you know, just move it, kind of center it. say I like this one, but I'm gonna copy it. So let's add a page right here, and then let's copy this whole thing, and let's try some different colors. So we don't lose this, we're gonna make a copy, and we're gonna put this here. Boom, okay, so now let's try this. We'll just do colors for now. We can try fonts later, but watch what happens. Look at that, that's so cool. These colors, if you like any of these, and you can hit them twice, so you don't have to just hit it once. You can hit it twice and kind of shuffle the colors in this palette. And you know, not all of them are gonna be awesome, but some of them are gonna turn out really good. Let's see if we find one that we like. That one was good. And if you find one and you went back, you can just hit Command Z and it would undo and it goes back one, or undo goes back another one, right? So if you hit this too fast and like, oh no, what was that last one? Hit that Command Z. So just play around with this. Some of these can be good. Maybe the flowers are nice, but the text isn't the right color. You can come in here and then just pick the text color, you know, and make it white and see how that looks. Like that looks really cool. And sometimes it doesn't, like that leaf we picked was that color and now it's not. So we can come back in here and just pick this color again. You can come in here and go boom right there, see? And if this is hard to see, we can come in here, you know, and whoops, one at a time, you can go one at a time, and maybe that's the color you want, or whatever. So have fun with this. This turned out really good too. I kinda like this. Maybe this with that light color, let's try that. So we'll come in here, click on the color, and maybe, you know, we can always use the eyedropper tool. Yeah. I like that. So was it that one? I think. No. Yeah, that's good too. And honestly, you could do it with the palettes too, with the fonts. So let's try that. I'm gonna copy this one. I really like this color, but we'll do another add page and we'll copy this. Copy. I don't think the fonts are gonna work as well, but we'll give it a try. Okay, here we go. These are the trending fonts and colors. Not bad, that didn't turn out too bad. Let's try this Strictan. Not bad, oh, that's kinda neat, that font. So you can try and play around with fonts and colors. You know, some might be too big and you're gonna have to adjust, but let's see. Yeah, kind of neat. So have fun with that. All the free colors, look how easy it is to change the colors around, and then, you know, you can try something like that. That turned out really well, and I think that turned out really well. So that's my tip on how to do flower wreaths and stuff. Now, this was just one of them. If we go back and we look at the elements, you can see all these different wreaths, and each one of these you can color and stuff like that. And you can do each one, you can do a different font. Like there's tons of designs, and this is just one of the magic recommendations. You can come back out here and look at all these wreaths as well, and then just so many. And the thing I like about the wreath is you already have a shape. So you can cut it like I did, or you can just leave it like that and then add to it because you already have this round shape. And some of them aren't perfectly round. Some of them have more flowers on the sides and things like that. But just a ton of them. A lot of them are pro, but a lot of them are free on here. So I did this for free on the free version. You can do the same. Play around with the colors, play around with that. The reason why I like cutting it is because then I make mine my own, and it's so different than everybody else's. As I add more leaves and flowers everywhere, you're starting to add your own design elements to it. So have fun with this. Hopefully you can use these techniques in other designs, not just Mother's Day, but throughout the year. So that is it for this video. Thanks so much for watching this video. Hopefully this video was super helpful for you. If it was, make sure to give it a thumbs up. If you like it, it really helps in the algorithm. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, make sure to hit that subscribe button right there. And the question of the day for this video is, Have you used flowers in your Canva designs before? Let me know that in the comments. Have you used flowers in your t-shirt designs, in your Canva designs? Love to hear it. I think this is one that's not used as much, but I think it can be very powerful because of all the colors and things. I think it'll do really well. So thanks again for watching. If you want to see more videos about Canva tutorials, make sure to click on these right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.